हेलो स्टूडेंट, वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन माय सुमित कोचिंग क्लास माय सेल्फ सुमदन पाटिल एंड वी हैव स्टार्टेड द यूनिट नंबर वन नंबर सिस्टम फॉर क्लास नाइन सीबीएसई बोर्ड. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द बेसिक इन नंबर सिस्टम. सो व्हाट इज इन बाय नंबर सिस्टम, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सेट्स आर देयर. सो एक्चुअली द सेट्स आर नेचुरल नंबर सेट, देन after that whole number set, then set of integers, set of rational, irrational, and then set of reals. We have also seen the T diagram for that, and later on we have also discussed about the representation of rational numbers, okay, on the number line. Okay, now in the today's lecture we are going to discuss about the irrational number. What is meant by irrational number, and let us see them and how to represent also that irrational number on the number line. In the previous standard also we have discussed about that, but also in detail about the irrational number we will discuss in this lecture. Now irrational number, so what is meant by irrational number? In this previous section we have seen about this actually. So the concept of rational number, now what is my rational number and what is my irrational number? Actually we are interested in irrational number. We have seen about the rational number. Okay, what is irrational number? Let us see that. In previous section we have seen the concept of rational number. Now today we are going to discuss about the irrational number. What is my rational number? A number R is said to be a rational number if it can be written in the form of P and Q. Am I right? So if we can write any number in this form P upon Q, where P and Q are what? P and Q are what? Integers, and Q is never zero. So this is the definition of rational number. So what is meant by irrational then? Irrational means what? The number which are not rational. Okay. So and the number which are not of this form are called as irrational. So number which are not rational are called as irrational. Means what? If we cannot write the number in the form of P upon Q, okay, so if we cannot write the number in the form of P upon Q, then that number is called as what? Irrational number. If we cannot write the number in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are what? Integers, and Q is never zero, is called as what? Irrational number. So as you know in previous standard also in basic things, you know that some irrational numbers, okay, you are familiar with irrational numbers. So some examples of irrational numbers that we now here see, so you already know that there are infinitely many rationals. Okay, so we have seen that there are infinitely many rational. In previous lecture we have discussed about this. Now we also have infinitely many irrationals. Okay, so we also have infinitely many irrational numbers also, and some examples are like this here. See, this root 2 is irrational number. We have shown that root 2 in on the number line also in previous lecture, sorry, in previous standard. Root 3 is also irrational. Root 15 is also irrational. So this pi is very well known number. It is a ratio of radius with its circumference, ratio of radius of circle with its circumference. Okay, so this is pi. It is an irrational number. And now this is what also irrational number, 0.10 11 01, like this. Okay, so this is also an irrational number. One more note here, it is very important. So recall that when we use the symbol root, we assume that, so if we use this symbol root, we assume that it is the positive square root of the number. Because if we take the square root of 4, see here, if we take the square root of 4, what is the answer of this? It means what? Plus 2, or also it is minus 2. Okay, but here we just only consider the positive square root of the number, and it is 2, like this. We don't consider here minus 2. So we assume that it is the positive root, square root of the number. Okay, now let us see about the Pythagoras. Okay, it is the history. Okay, so Pythagorean in Greece, Pythagorean means they are the followers of a great mathematicians and philosopher Pythagoras. Okay, so they were the first to discover the number which are not rationals around 400 BC. Okay, so they have first discovered that there are some numbers which are not rational, means they are not follow the properties of rational numbers. Okay, so around near about 400 BC, these numbers are called irrational numbers. Okay, so they call these numbers as irrational numbers because they cannot be written in the form of the ratio P upon Q. That's why they call them as a irrational numbers. Okay, so there are many myths surrounding in the discovery of the irrational numbers by the Pythagorean. So Hipparchus, this is one of the follower of this Pythagorean. In all the myths, Hipparchus has an unfortunate end, either for the discovering that root 2 is an irrational number or disclosing the secret about the root 2 to people outside the secret of Pythagorean sect. Okay, so Hipparchus unfortunately ends. Okay, so either for discovering that root 2 is an irrational number, so he has discovered that root 2 is irrational number, or about root 2 to people outside the secret Pythagorean sect. Okay, so now some concept about this irrational numbers. Okay, so Pythagorean proved that root 2 is irrational number. So later, in the approximately 425 BC, okay, Theodos of Cyan shows that, also they have shows that these numbers are irrational. See, these number root 3, root 6, root 7, root 10, root 11, root 12, root 13, root 14, all that are also irrational numbers. So they have proved this root 2 is irrational number around 425 BC. Okay, and also this Synod of Cyan shows this all numbers are also irrational. Okay, so also we can show these all numbers on the number line. Now, as to pi, it was known to various cultures for the thousands of years. Okay, so it was proved to be irrational by numbered and legendary only in the late 1700s. Okay, so these two scientists, these two mathematicians, they have proved this actually. Okay, so that pi is an irrational number. D. Alembert, actually the name of scientist D. Alembert and Legendre. Okay, so we will discuss about that also, their work. The collection of all rational numbers and irrational numbers together make up what we call the collection of real number, which is denoted by what? R. Okay, so if we collect all the rational and irrational numbers, what I get? We get a set of real numbers. Okay, so means set of real numbers, there does not any number which is either rational or irrational. So if we take the set of real, then the number either it is rational or irrational. Okay, so therefore if we collect all rational or irrational, what we get? We get a set of real number. Okay, and it is denoted by R. So set of real number contains all the rational and irrational, and togetherly we call as what? Set of real number, and it is denoted by what? R. The real number is either rational or irrational. I have told you about that. So the real number is either rational or irrational. Every real number, it is very important. Okay, so every real number is represented by unique point on the number line. This is shown by these two mathematicians. Okay, so every real number is represented by a unique point on the number line. Also, every point on the number line represents a unique real number. Means what? That point represent either rational number or irrational number. Got it? Okay, so that point either represent rational number or irrational number, because that's why we just call it as a real line. Okay, so real number or number line. Okay, because all the numbers are there. Okay, and this is why we call the number line the real number line. Okay, so that's why we called it as what? A real number line. So this is, that's why we call this as a real number line. So let us see about these two mathematicians, R. Dedekind and G. Cantor. Sorry for this, not Legendre and D. Alembert shows that these two scientists, these two mathematicians shows that the corresponding to every real number, there is a point on the real number line, and corresponding to every point on the number line, there exists a unique real number. Okay, so in the 1870s, two German mathematicians, Cantor and Dedekind, shows this. They have the huge work in mathematics also. Okay, they have done huge work in mathematics. So as you go in go for higher study, you just find some concept which are discovered by these two mathematicians. So set theory, also there are there is a major contribution of this, and also in calculus, this Dedekind make a huge work. Okay, so you can find some concept in your higher studies, derived or introduced by these two mathematicians. Okay, now the example, locate the root 2 on the number line. So let us see that. First, consider the square OABC. Okay, now having one length of each side is 1. Now join OB. Now what is the length of OB? Let us see. If we apply the Pythagoras theorem, why? Because every angle of square is 90 degrees. So this is 90 degree. Am I right? And therefore what? Therefore it is to see how it is easy to see how that Greeks might have discovered root 2. Let us see how that Greeks show or discover root 2. Consider the square, this square OABC, and each side of 1 unit in length. So then by the Pythagoras theorem, what I get? OB is equal to this OB is equal to what? OB is equal to OA square. OB is equal to OA square plus OB square. Now therefore, if we take square root, OB is equal to root over OA square plus AB square. But what is OA? 1, it's square, AB 1, and if we take that, we get a root 2. So what is the value of AB? So the value of AB is what? It is a root 2. Okay, so sorry, OB, OB is nothing but root 2. So we just have seen OB is equal to root 2. Let us see how we locate this root 2 on the number line. Now take the number line. Okay, and these are the numbers. Okay, so let us just take as it is this square on this number line. So this from this is your 1 actually. See, this is your 1 and this is your, sorry, this is your 0, not 1, and this is your 1 here. Okay, now take them as O and A, OABC. Okay, so they are actually your OABC. Okay, I just map this square as it is on this number line, because from O to A the length is what? 1. Okay, so now OB is what? OB is nothing but root 2. And if we just OB is nothing but root 2, see, so using compass, so what I get? If we use the compass, see, this distance is nothing but root 2. OB distance is nothing but root 2. Am I right? So if we use the compass, take that point of compass on this point O and take the distance OB as root 2. Okay, so whatever the distance will be, root 2, and just using compass take the curve. Okay, okay, and that whatever the point here, so this is the point what? This is the point P, and that point P should be what? This is root 2. Okay, so here what I get? This is root 2. Are you getting this? How I just draw that? Okay, this is your root 2. See here, whatever this distance OB, so here we have the OB is equal to root 2, and same distance I have taken, and using compass I just made the curve, and that line which intersect that curve which intersect the number line, okay, that point of intersection is nothing but your root 2. Same, this OP distance is nothing but what? This distance OP is nothing but from this O to P, this distance is nothing but your root 2. Are you getting this? Same, in the same way you can show how to locate the root 3 on the number line. So let us see that also. Now let us see the second example, locate root 3 on the number line. So for that we just follow the same step as that of previous. We use the same procedure to locate this root 3 on the next line. Okay, so take the number line, and now this is the root 2. Okay, so we have locate the root 2 on the number line, same. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to draw the perpendicular line at the point B. So we have to draw the perpendicular line to OB. Okay, so now, so just draw, construct the BD of unit length perpendicular to OB, so whose length is also 1. So this is the perpendicular. Okay, now BD is perpendicular. See, this BD is perpendicular. This BD is perpendicular to what? OB. Okay, so its length is 1 actually. Now if you observe, this is again OBD is a right angle triangle. So if I want OD, once again I just use what? Pythagoras theorem, because we have OB. OB is root 2, BD is 1. So therefore by Pythagoras theorem, OD is nothing but root of root 2 square plus 1 square. So root 2 square is what? Root 2 square is nothing but your 4. So inside the square root it is 4. Okay, so this is 4 plus 1, and 4 plus 1 is it is not 4, its square is 2, square of root 2 is 2, and 2 plus 1 is nothing but what? 3, and root over 3 is there. So this is your root 3. OD is nothing but root 3. Now what we have to do, just take the compass. Okay, so using compass with center O, and radius OD, draw the arc. Okay, so from here, okay, so just draw the arc. Now this is the arc, and this Q represent what? Q represent your root 3. Now OQ is nothing but what? Distance root 3. Okay, then Q corresponding to what? Root 3. So this is the procedure to draw the line. So this is from O to Q, the distance is what? Root 3. See, this is the simplest method. Actually, also you have locate this root 3 on the number line in previous standard. Okay, so now let us start the exercise 1.2. So the first example is state whether the following statements are true or false. Okay, also justify your answer. So the first statement is every irrational number is real number. Is it true or false? Yes, it is true actually. Why? Because every irrational number is a real number. Why? Because a real number is a collection of what? Rational and irrational. So whatever the real, whatever the number is there in the set of real number, either it is rational or irrational. Okay, it means what? Every irrational number is a subset of real number. Okay, and therefore every irrational number is what? Real number, because every set of irrational number is a subset of real number. Okay, so this is a true statement, as a set of all real is a collection of rational and irrational. And another justification you can give here, so every rational, because a set of irrational number is a subset of real number. Okay, so this is a true statement. Second, every point on the number line is of the form root m, where m is a natural number. No, this is false actually. Why? Because if we think about the negative numbers, they cannot be written in the form of square root. So no negative number can be in the form of square root of the any natural number. Okay, so we cannot locate, we don't have the number root minus 4. Okay, so that's why we cannot locate this point on the number line. So therefore this is a false statement. Okay, third is every real number is an irrational number. So these two are actually connected. If you observe this first statement, okay, these two are connected. So in the first statement, every irrational is a number is a real number, because irrational is a subset of real, but real is not subset of this. Okay, so therefore what? Every real number is an irrational number. This is a false statement. Okay, so this is false statement. Why? Because there are some rational which are real also. okay, real number contain the rational as well as irrational. Okay, so therefore this is a false statement. For example, 4 is real but not irrational. Okay, 4 is a rational number, it is not a irrational number. Getting this? Okay, next example. Okay, once again just locate this root 5 on the number line. Okay, now take the number line. Just we use this same concept as earlier that we have used. So now what we have to do, we just take the two points here. Okay, so from O to A, this is 1, this is 2 here. Okay, so total distance is what from O to A is what? 2, because this is 0, this is 1 and this is 2. This is 2 here. Okay, now this is your 2. Okay, this is your 2. Okay, this is your 0 and O represents 0 and this is your 1. Okay, so this total distance is nothing but 2. This total distance is nothing but 2. Now this is AB is nothing but 1. Once again, this is the right angle triangle. Okay, OAB. Now we can use the Pythagoras theorem, and we, using Pythagoras theorem, what is OB? OB is nothing but root 2 square plus 1 square, and this is 4 plus 1. So this is what? It is root over 2 square is nothing but 4, and 1 square is nothing but what? 1. So therefore 4 plus 1 is nothing but root 5. Okay, so therefore this is nothing but what? Your root 5. Now same here, using compass, take the center O. Okay, use the compass, take the center O and draw the arc. Take the center O and take the radius as OB. Okay, and draw an arc intersecting the number line like this. See here, your number line, that arc intersect the number line at the point P, and this P represent what? Root 5. Okay, and therefore then P corresponding to root 5 on the number line. So this is very simple procedure to locate the irrational on the number line. Okay, you can locate many irrational on the number line. So whatever the irrational number, use the proper procedure. Okay, now let us do some work at home. Okay, so first example, are the square root of all positive numbers irrational? Okay, if not, give an example of the square root of number that is rational number. Okay, are the square root of all positive integer is irrational? Okay, check whether all the square root of all positive number are the square root of all positive integer is irrational number. Okay, for example, if you take 4, its square root is 2, it is not irrational number. Okay, so therefore you can give the example. And second is locate root 5 on the number line. Okay, so you can locate the root 10 on the number line. So you can show that root 5 already we have seen. Show, locate root 10 on the number line. Okay, take 3 on the number line and 1. So 3 square is nothing but so you can take here, this is, suppose this is number line 0, 1, 2 and 3. So this is 0 here and this is 3 here. Okay, and just take this triangle 90 degree. Okay, and this is 1. This is use Pythagoras theorem. So this total distance is 3. 3 square plus 1 square is root 10. So this is, and this is the root 10. Okay, actually, and then draw the arc by taking this radius. Okay, so draw the arc by taking this center and this is radius. So you can draw that. Okay, you can locate that root 10 on the number line. So in this way we have seen this, how to represent, how, what is my irrational number, how to represent irrational number on the number line. Okay, we just revise that because we have seen that concept in previous standard. Okay, so 1.2 we have covered in this lecture. So tomorrow, in the next lecture, we'll discuss about the next concept. Okay, what is the decimal representation of the rational number? Okay, and then we'll discuss some examples on that also. So once again, if you like this video, just press the like button. If you have any doubts, just comment me. Okay, and don't forget to subscribe the channel, because you will get the indication of the next videos. Okay, so thank you.